So very good morning to all of you. So yesterday I could not engage the class due to network problem. Anyway, today I will continue. So in the first class we have discussed up to this Newton's third law of motion, and we have also discussed about what is a force, the definition of a force. So it is the external agency which tend to change the state of a body or a particle. When a force is applied to a body which is at rest, the body may remain in the state of rest or it may move with some velocity. So here in engineering mechanics, we will be using SI units. SI units for forces, Newton. So 1 Newton is the force required to accelerate a body of 1 kg mass by 1 m/s². Now, let us discuss the elements of a force or characteristics of a force. So now, a force can be identified in a given force system by the following characteristics. That is, by its magnitude, by its direction, by its line of application and point of application, line of action and point of application. And also, it can be also identified by its sense. So a force in a given force system can be identified by its magnitude, its direction, its line of action, and its point of application, and also the sense of a force. Now, the magnitude of force is nothing but the length of an arrow representing a force. The length of an arrow, if you measure the length of an arrow representing a force, it directly gives its magnitude. So the magnitude of force may be in Newton or kilonewton and its multiple. And the direction of the force is in which way the force is acting, in which way the force is acting. The direction of a force can be represented by an arrowhead. Now you can see the force is always represented by an arrow which has a tip and tire. So now the direction of force is identified by the direction of the tip of the force. Tip of the force. In our case, it is acting towards right direction. So if you reverse it, it will act in the other direction. So the direction of a force basically represented by an arrowhead. Now, the point of application, the tip of a force gives its point of application. Now here, the force is acting at a point. So since the force is acting in this direction, it will be acting at a point. So that gives you the point of application of a force. Now, next is the sense of a force. The sense of a force is in which way the force is acting, whether the force is acting towards positive direction, or it is acting towards negative direction, or if it is making any angle of inclination with respect to horizontal. The tip and tire of an arrow representing a force gives its sense. So a force can be identified in a given force system by its magnitude, its direction, its line of action, its point of application, and also by its sense. Now, in all our engineering mechanics problem, we'll be considering the force as a point force. That means it acts at a point. Now, a force which is acting at a fixed point is known as point force. Let us consider a man climbing a ladder. The weight of the man is not actually concentrated at a fixed point, but the purpose of analysis, it is assumed to be concentrated at a particular point. So in all our engineering mechanics problem, the force may act on a definite area, but we are going to consider all the forces as the point force. That means it acts at a point. So it simplifies the problem in engineering mechanics. Now, we know the definition of a force. Force is an external agency or an external force which change the state of a body or a particle. And it can be identified by this following. Now, there are different types of force system. Now, let us discuss one by one. Force system. If system of forces is nothing but which contains more than a single force. So, a force system is one wherein it contains more than one force. That means if two or more forces are acting on a particle, then it is said to be a force system. Such a force system is shown in figure. And now, you can see here, this is a given body and it is subjected to the forces having different magnitude, that is F1, F2, F3, F4, respectively. Now, A system of forces is nothing but which contains more than a single force, more than a single force acting on a body or acting on a particle. Now, there are nearly around 6 to 7 classification of system of forces. Now, the types of force system. So now we shall discuss what are the different types of force system. The types of force system are either it can be a coplanar force system, or it can be a non-coplanar force system, or it can be a collinear force system. So these are... Now, there are mainly three types of force system. One is coplanar force system, the other one is non-coplanar force system, the third one is collinear force system. Now again, under coplanar force system, we have three types. One is coplanar concurrent force system. Second one is coplanar non-concurrent force system. And the third one is coplanar parallel force system. Now we shall discuss one by one. Now here, if two or more forces are acting in a single plane. Now here you have an XY plane, And if two or more forces are acting in a single plane and their line of action passes through a single point. Now you can see here, it is an XY plane. Here you have four forces acting in different direction, F1, F2, F3, F4. And they are acting at a point. They are originating at a point. So the line of action of these forces originate at a point, originate from a point, F1, F2, F3, F4. So such a system of forces wherein the line of action of the all the forces, either it originates from a point or it can concentrate at a point. So if I reverse this direction of the arrowhead, so it will all act at a point. So such a system of forces wherein the line of action passes through a single point, it is said as a coplanar concurrent force system. You can see here, if two or more forces are acting in a single plane and their line of action passes through a single point, then it is said to be a coplanar concurrent force system. Now, under coplanar concurrent force system, again, you have coplanar concurrent force system, coplanar non-concurrent force system, and coplanar parallel force system. So this figure refers to coplanar concurrent force system. Now you can see the next figure. Here, you have a single plane, XY plane. Here, four forces are acting in different direction, And here, the line of action of these forces are not concentrating at a point. In this case, the line of action of all these forces are meeting at this point, or it is originating from this point. So such a system for of forces is known as coplanar concurrent force system. So if you look at this figure, the line of action of all these forces are not meeting at a single point. So such a system of forces is known as coplanar non-concurrent force system. Now, the third one is coplanar parallel force system. Again, you can consider an XY plane. Here you have four forces acting in the upward direction, and you can see here the line of action, of these forces are essentially parallel to each other, or it is parallel to one of the reference axes. Now in this case, it is parallel to y axis. If you consider an XY plane, if I consider an XY plane here, and here four forces are acting in on a single plane, and the line of action of these forces are essentially parallel to each other. So such a system of forces is known as the like parallel force system. Again, you have an unlike parallel force system. Here, the difference between like parallel force system and unlike parallel force system, here all the forces are acting in one direction. In this case, the line of action of these forces are essentially parallel to each other, but the direction or the sense of the force is in different directions. So F1 is acting upwards, F2 is acting downwards, F3 is acting upwards, and F4 is acting downwards. So basically, it is acting on a single plane, and the line of action of these forces are parallel to each other. So there are two types of parallel force system. One is like parallel force system. The other one is unlike parallel force system. Now, we know what is a coplanar concurrent force system, coplanar parallel force system. Now, next is non-coplanar force system, non-coplanar force system. Here, if two or more forces are acting in different plane, the forces constitute a non-coplanar force system. Such a system of forces can be either non-coplanar concurrent force system, non-coplanar non-concurrent force system, non-coplanar parallel force system. So non-coplanar, here you can see this word, it is not acting in a single plane. The forces are acting in different plane. Hence it is called as non-coplanar force system. Again, under non-coplanar force system, you have three types. One is non-coplanar concurrent force system. The other one is non-coplanar non-concurrent force system. The third one is non-coplanar parallel force system. Now let us discuss one by one. Now here you have forces acting in different plane. So X, Y, Z. So the forces are acting in different plane, but the line of action of all these forces, you can see, it is concentrating at a single point, So the system of forces are acting in different plane, but the line of action of all these forces are essentially meeting at a single point, are originating from a single point. So such a system of forces acting in different plane, but the line of action of these forces are meeting or concentrating at a point is called as non-coplanar concurrent force system. Now here, again, the second one. Here the system of forces are acting in different plane, XYZ plane, but the line of action of these forces are not concentrating at a point, are not meeting at a point. So such a system of forces acting in different plane and the line of action of these forces do not pass through a single point is called as non-coplanar non-concurrent force system. Now you can see here, if two or more forces are acting on different plane but do not pass through the same point, they constitute a non-coplanar non-concurrent force system. So that is the second classification of system of forces under non-coplanar force system. Next is non-coplanar parallel force system. Now you can see here, the system of forces are acting in different plane, but the line of action of these forces are parallel to each other, So such a system of forces is known as the non-coplanar parallel force system. And the last one is collinear force system. Here, the forces are, all the three forces, F1, F2, F3, they're acting in this direction. And the line of action of all these forces are coinciding in with each other, You can see here, this is the line of action of this force, and this is the line of action of this one, and this is the line of action of this one. And all are in a same line. The line of action of all these forces are in a same line. So such a system of forces is known as collinear force system. Here, if the line of action of two or more forces coincides with one another, it is called as a collinear force system. So we know the definition of a force, correct? And how it can be identified in a given force system by its magnitude, direction, line of action, point of application, and sense. And we know what is a force system, which contains more than a single force. And we know the types of force system, that is coplanar force system, non-coplanar force system, collinear force system. And again, under coplanar force system, we have three types: coplanar concurrent force system, coplanar non-concurrent force system, coplanar parallel force system. Again, under non-coplanar force system, again, you have three types: non-coplanar concurrent force system, non-coplanar non-concurrent force system, and the third one is non-coplanar parallel force system. Again, you may have one more classification under non-coplanar force system, that is non-coplanar non-parallel force system. Non-coplanar parallel force system. And you can also have one more non-coplanar force system, that is non-coplanar non-parallel force system. So these are the figures which explains the different kinds of non-coplanar force system, and also this collinear force system. So here the line of action of all these forces coincides with each other. Next, you can see here non-collinear force system. You can see here the line of action of all these forces are not coinciding. It is acting in different direction. Here, these are some of the figures which shows you the non-collinear force system. Now, next we shall move on to a concept known as principle of transmissibility of force. Principle of transmissibility. Here you can see this word transmissibility means that is transferring from one point to the other point. Transferring from one point to the other point. So the principle of transmissibility state that the external effect of a force on a body remains unchanged or unaltered if the same force is shifted to any other point along its line of action. So the principle of transmissibility of forces states that the external effect of a force on a body remains unchanged or unaltered if the same force is shifted to any other point along its line of action. So that is the subject to condition that the system of forces should act along its line of action. Now you can see this figure. So this is a body, so which is subjected to a force of magnitude F at point O. At point O, it is subjected to a force of magnitude F at point O. So now the same force can be shifted to another point that is O dash, subject to the condition that this point should be along the same line of action. So that means the external effect of this force on a body remain unchanged even if the force is shifted to any other point along its line of action. Now you can see the description. The principle states that a force can be transmitted or transferred from one point to another point along the same line of action such that the effect produced by the force on the body remain unchanged. That means the external effect of the force on the body remain unchanged or unaltered. So let us consider a rigid body subjected to a force F at point O as shown in figure. According to the principle of transmissibility, the force can be shifted or transmitted to a new point O dash along the same line of action such that the net effect or the external effect remains unchanged. So this is a very important concept. It is principle of transmissibility. Next is principle of superposition of forces. Principle of superposition of forces. The principle of superposition of forces states that the net effect of a system of forces on a body is same as that of the combined effect of individual forces on the body. That means the principle states that the net effect of a system of forces on a body is same as that of the combined effect of individual forces on the body. That means you are going to take the summation of the effects of all the forces. The net effects of that is known as principle of superposition of forces. Next is principle of physical independence of forces. So now here you have a word independence. That means the principle states that the action of a force on a body is not affected by the action of any other force on the body. That means the effect of that force is independent in nature. So it is not affected by any other force. The effect is not affected by any other force. So that is known as the principle of physical independence of forces. Am I audible to you? Hello?
Yes.
I'm audible. You have any problem with my voice and modulation?
Yes, sir, you are audible.
Okay. So are you following the concept?
Yes, sir.
Okay. No problem with my presentation, I hope. Okay. Anyway, I wish to have offline classes rather than online classes. What to do, we hope best. So the college will reopen shortly and we'll meet offline. Okay. Till then, we have to continue with this. Again, in the offline classes, I'll be sharing this information to all of you. Okay. Now, next is resolution of a force. So this concept is very important. Resolution of a force is very important. So here, the main idea behind this resolution of a force is here, we are going to divide a given force along two mutually perpendicular directions. two mutually perpendicular direction. Now you can see here, we have an XY plane. We have an XY plane here, XY plane. Here, you have a force of magnitude F. So which makes an angle theta, theta with respect to the horizontal axis. Now, the concept of resolution of a force is, we can divide the single force into two components, one along the horizontal direction and one along the vertical direction. Now here, on an XY plane, we have a force of magnitude F and which makes an angle theta with respect to the horizontal axis. So there is a concept of resolution of a force is, we can divide this force into two components, one along the horizontal direction, the other along the vertical direction. So these components along horizontal and vertical directions are, these are called as the rectangular components. So these are called as the rectangular components. Now, if you take the cos and sine relation, cos theta. Now, if you consider the cos theta is nothing but the adjacent by the hypotenuse, correct? The adjacent by the hypotenuse. That is, adjacent is f of x and the hypotenuse is f. So here, cos theta is f of x by f. Or else, f of x will be equal to f cos theta. So this horizontal component is nothing but it is f of x is equal to f cos theta. So similarly, if you take the sine relation, so sine theta is nothing but opposite by the hypotenuse. So here the opposite side is fy. So this is the opposite side, fy, that divided by the hypotenuse, that is f. So which reads fy is equal to f sine theta. So the concept of resolution of a force is nothing but we can divide a given force into two components along two mutually perpendicular direction, one along the horizontal direction, the other along the vertical direction. So now once you find these components, once you find these rectangular components, we can add these rectangular components, that is f of x plus f of y. That is, you can get back the original force, you can get back the original force, that is f of x square plus f of y square root. So that will give you the original force. So the idea behind this resolution of a force, so this concept will be very helpful if there is any unknown force in a given force system. Suppose you have a force system, one of the force is not having any magnitude. So we can find the magnitude of an unknown force in a given force system by the method of or the concept of resolution of a force. So here, the process of dividing or splitting of a force into two rectangular components, horizontal and vertical, is known as resolution of a force, as shown in figure. In this figure, F is the force which makes an angle theta with the horizontal axis, and it can be resolved into two components, namely F of X and F of Y along the X axis and Y axis respectively. Now, if on the other hand, if theta is the angle made by the force F with the vertical axis, then obviously F of Y is F cos theta and F of X is F sin theta. That means you can resolve a given force. You can resolve a given force either with respect to X axis, or it can also be resolved with respect to Y axis. So there is no hard and fast rule that you have to resolve only with respect to x-axis. You can also resolve with respect to y-axis. Now, if I consider the angle theta with respect to y-axis, I will consider this as y-axis. Then f of x, this becomes f of x, and this becomes f of x, and this becomes f of y. So then f of y will be f cos theta, and f of x is f sin theta. So either you can resolve with respect to x-axis, or either you can resolve with respect to y-axis. Both will give you the same values. That is, f of x is f cos theta, here f of y is f cos theta, and here f of y is f sin theta, and here f of x is f sin theta. So either you can resolve the given force along, either along x-axis or y-axis. So anything... any clarification with this concept? Anyone having any doubts? You can ask freely. Only thing is, a given force is divided into two components along two mutually perpendicular directions. And this concept will be very helpful in finding any unknown force in a given force system. So when we take up the numerical problems, you will understand this concept better. Next is composition of forces. So in this case, it is a resolution of a force wherein a force has been divided into two components along two mutually perpendicular direction. Now, the next concept is composition of forces. Composition of forces means you are going to combine two forces into a single force and finding out that combined effect, So which is nothing but the resultant, So in the earlier case, a given force has been divided into two components, whereas in this case, two forces or any number of forces can be combined into a single force such that the net effect produced by the single force will be equal to the algebraic sum of effect produced by the individual forces. Now you can see here the definition, composition of forces. It is the process of combining a number of forces into a single force such that the net effect produced by the single force is equal to the algebraic sum of the effect produced by the individual force. So this single force or the combined effect is called as the resultant force, which produces the same effect on the body as that produced by the individual forces acting together. Now, the resultant of a given force system, that means we are going to combine the number of forces and finding out the combined effect. So this resultant, the magnitude and direction of this resultant force can be informed by using the law of parallelogram of forces and also the law of triangular of forces, law of parallelogram of forces, and also by the law of triangular of forces. Now, so sigma f of x is the algebraic sum of the components of the forces along x-axis, and sigma f of x here, we shall see that how to combine. Now here, a body acted upon by a number of forces. Now you can see here, F1 is acting on this body and it makes an angle theta with respect to the horizontal axis. Now here, F2 is acting vertically downwards, and F3 is acting at this point and it makes an angle theta 2 with respect to the vertical axis. And F4 is acting along the x direction. Now we shall take the sum of the algebraic sum of the forces which are acting along x-axis, And now I think the time is running out. So I request all of you to mark your attendance in the chat box. So we shall continue in the next class. So all of you mark your attendance in the chat box. Anybody is having any doubts with the concept? Anyway, on Saturday we should. Hello? Anyone having any doubts or whether my pace is okay or I need to slow down the pace? Are you able to catch? You can ask.
No doubt, sir.
Is that Srishti Singh? Okay, fine. So, okay, thank you so much. I think all of you have marked your attendance in the chat box. So I'll be ending the session. Have a nice day. Stay at home. Stay safe. Till then, goodbye. So we shall meet on Saturday at 10:45. So again, I will explain the concept of resolution of force and the composition of force, how to resolve a force and how to find out the combined effect of the result. So I'll be ending the session.